Well, we're glad that you've been with us this week here at Area 5. We've been talking about hydration and how important it is for us to maintain health and wellness. And we have a guest with us today. Nicole is from Angels of Mercy Home Care, and she's going to share with us, from her perspective, the people that she works with, how we can best hydrate and some good principles for good health care. So, Nicole, thanks for being with us today, and share with us what's on your heart.
Okay. So related to hydration, which is one of the big risk factors for rehospitalization for all of our patients and elderly, anyone over the age of 60, is that finding that balance between how much intake we should actually have for hydration. So in general, when we are thinking of how much fluid to take in, we would like you to take in approximately one cup of fluid for every 20 pounds that you weigh. And in order to know how much fluid to take in, you would want to weigh daily. And if you have diagnoses or conditions that would state otherwise, such as congestive heart failure or heart disease or high blood pressure, or you've been put on a fluid restriction, you should be safe in taking in one cup of fluid for every 20 pounds that you weigh. If you do weigh daily and you do have an increase in weight and you do have a diagnosis that would indicate congestive heart failure or hypertension, if you weigh and you are over 2 pounds in one day, 3 pounds in 5 days, or you gain 5 pounds in seven, you'd want to consult your physician regarding that. But the body is made up of about 60% water for the normal average human being. And as we get older, are over the age of 60 approximately, our body is made up of about 52% water for men and 46 for women, which is an issue related to dehydration. So it's also a frequent cause of rehospitalization. Causes of dehydration can be your medications that you take that are taking fluid off your body, fever, elevated temperatures outdoors, we're just coming out of summer. It can also be the cooler temperatures because we do a lot of mouth breathing or coughing in the winter time. So we can also lose water that way. Sweating, and then just in general, poor water intake. Some of us don't like to take in too much water because we don't want to have to get up to go to the bathroom, but it is important to our overall general health to make sure we're taking in plenty of water. Some of the diagnoses that might you might want to be aware of in case you're not sure how much water you should be able to take in, what your doctor has prescribed, would be your hypertension, diabetes, heart disease, because those meds might make you more susceptible to dehydration, or you may be on a restriction from the physician. As we get older and we eat less, we're supposed to be taking about half of our water. Daily intake is through foods or fruits or juices that we eat, and then the other half is typically in the form of an actual drink. And as we get older and we're eating less, then we're taking in less, causing us to be susceptible to dehydration. Some of the signs and symptoms of dehydration would be if you have a low blood pressure, so if you're monitoring your blood pressure daily, and you see it going down significantly, you're not feeling well, sunken eyes, confusion, your caregiver or your loved one may be talking to you about being more lethargic or tired. You may feel more weak or be getting muscle cramps, otherwise known as Charlie horses. You may have no tears when you're crying, headaches, dizziness, nausea, forgetfulness. You could even, in a severe case, you might have, or one of the first signs and symptoms could be that with the confusion, you would have more of the symptoms of like Alzheimer's or, some sort of a dementia, but it could be related to dehydration. With less body fluid, then we have less kidney function. And our kidneys take off of our body the toxins that we have and it removes it from our blood. And if that builds up, then we can have other issues related to the kidneys. So we want to stay hydrated to keep the kidneys functioning well. Concentrated urine might be something that you see initially yourself. And so you want to make sure that if your urine's dark in the morning, that you want to make sure that you're staying hydrated. I like to use the contact lens theory, is that the kidneys are kind of like a soft contact that we wear in our eyes. As long as they're wet, they're working very well. If they get dry, the contact does not feel good to the eye, gets hard, and actually you have to take it out, and it's nice and crispy in your hand. If I re-wet that contact, I can put it back in, and we're good to go. So staying hydrated will help keep the kidneys functioning well. Keeping water next to your bed, keeping water next to your chair, reminding your loved one to take a drink all your meds with water would be a wonderful thing in the morning, just to get you started with your water intake. If you're concerned, like all of us are, about getting up in the night and urinating, having to go to the bathroom all night long, then try to take your water intake. The suggestion would be to do that before 3 o'clock. And then maybe by your evening meal, around 5 or 6, you would have your water intake for the day. And that will slow down your need to run to the bathroom throughout the night. Another risk that we have and we see with our patients and in general in the public is the risk for falling. So if we're dehydrated, we're going to be at a greater risk for falls. That fall could occur in the bathroom. It could occur when you're changing positions rapidly, or in general, just being too weak to get up safely. So staying hydrated will help prevent falls as well, if your fall is related to dehydration or your potential fall. Another thing is constipation, and we don't like to discuss this, but constipation is a big issue when we're over the age of 60, and staying hydrated will help prevent constipation, which could reduce your need for additional medication, and no one likes to take medicine more than they need. Along with the fewer falls, improved strength and stability, and overall improvement of your generalized weakness would be a big benefit to staying hydrated. If you find yourself dehydrated and you do not have a sodium restriction, you could rehydrate safely with a half of your fluid intake of water and half of it as a sports drink. So if you were drinking 4 ounces of water, you would want to match that with 4 ounces of a sports drink. If you have a sodium restriction, you would probably want to replace the sports drink with Pedialyte or something similar due to the sodium content. If you have diabetes, another alternative might be Gatorade 2, G2. It has lower sugar. So you wouldn't want to just do the sports drink. You would want to do like a 50-50 on that intake. And that would allow you to get your electrolytes in order to help keep the water on board so you feel better. Dehydration, if you suspect that you might be dehydrated and you would want to call your physician, they can do labs, depending on the area you live. They can even send a lab to your home and you can have a urinalysis done. They can do some blood work, make sure your kidneys are running okay and that everything is all good. So the physician would need to be contacted as well. They can also monitor your electrolyte levels. If we have a sodium restriction and you're over the age of 50, you might be on a sodium restriction of approximately 1500 milligrams per day. You're probably not going to retain a lot of fluid, so you really want to, again, weigh daily. If you're not on a sodium restriction, you're probably taking in about 2300 to 3400 grams of sodium a day. And as you go over the 2500 range, you might find yourself retaining more fluid. You actually could find that you'll notice your feet, your hands, and your legs might be swollen. That doesn't mean that we just stop drinking. It doesn't mean that we can be dehydrated at the same time as we are in fluid overload. So you want to consult your physician, and you want to do that as soon as possible so we can keep you home safely. Regarding patients or yourself, if you have heart failure, that is a big one in the community. That is a big one that people are dealing with. You want to make sure you're following your diet, follow your fluid restriction. However, you want to make sure that you're keeping yourself hydrated and not restricting the fluids beyond what the physician has ordered. And there could be a potential sodium restriction as well for you. If you have a restriction and you find yourself thirsty and you're close to your daily limit for fluid, an option for you would be to chew gum, have some hard candy, use lemon juice, suck on a lemon. You could put lemon over ice chips, and that would help you feel like you had a drink. It actually does help. Watch for hidden sodium in canned and frozen meals, and read your labels and remember that the label is per serving, not for the entire meal. So one box meal might say it would be for maybe two servings. You can be dehydrated and in fluid overload at the same time. And to elaborate on that, if you're taking water pills, could be furosemide, torsemide, any of the diuretics, that is pulling water from your veins and your tissues. If you take that with water, that will continue to work and be effective. But however, if you take it with a soda pop or a fruit drink, then you might, or not enough fluid, then you might find out that you are not having those meds being as effective as they should be. They can dehydrate you, the kidney function would be poor, but you can still remain swollen in your tissues. Your feet, your shoes may not fit, your pants legs may be tight, even in your abdomen, it might be not that you gained weight so much from eating too much, it might be fluid as well. So just finding that balance between being dehydrated, staying hydrated, and making sure that you're following the necessary guidelines for your diagnosis is very important. Other than that, I just wanted to say that dehydration, again, you want to stay away from the ERs, you want to stay away from the hospital, you want to stay at home safely, and so keeping yourself hydrated would be a wonderful thing, and you want to consult your physician if you have any other questions.
Well, thanks, Nicole. Obviously, Nicole and Angels of Mercy and Area 5 are great resources for you, and the content she shared today is really applicable at every age. I'm approaching 60, and so this stuff is very interesting to me and useful for me. But for every age, whether you're an athlete, whether you're a mother with young children, certainly as you're getting older, staying hydrated is extremely important for our well-being and our health. And as Nicole mentioned, if you do have any changes in your diet or in your health, or you're feeling differently than you used to, make sure again that you consult with your physician before making any self-diagnoses. Very important that you are consulting with him or her so that you're able to have an expert opinion as you go on. But thank you, Nicole, for being with us. Great content.
Thank you.
We appreciate you being with us. Any last words?
Yeah, actually, you mentioned mothers with children. One of the things that we notice in babies in dehydration is the top of their head, their soft spot will be much softer, maybe sunken in, and you'll notice that their diapers are dry. So, and then again with babies, one of the first signs would be their mouth, their tongue may be dry, and also no tears when they're crying. And so we want to make sure that they're hydrated as well. So,
well, we want you to be healthy and happy, and we at Area 5 are here to be a resource to you. Stay hydrated, drink lots, and enjoy your life.